Hello, Mike Celona here. If you've been watching our videos lately, you know we've been putting out some content detailing our approach to finding the practical application of traditional martial arts techniques. For myself, who originally came up in the traditional Korean art of Tang Soo Do, there lately has been an abundance of relevant material put out there by great content creators contributing to this particular topic. My approach has always been to absorb what I can and apply it to my own training. The issue is this: over the last decade and a half, I've realized that the material that we teach here in our studio only slightly resembles its parent styles of Tang Soo Do and Taekwondo, and has really grown and evolved into its own style, hence the adoption of the Pilsung Moo Do name. So where does that leave me on my quest to find functionality in a traditional style? I think that by researching the past and finding the hidden meaning in those techniques, we can better understand the future. I'm aware that there is a divide in the traditional martial arts world between those who are willing to change or think outside the box in an effort to modernize traditional systems such as mine, and those who are so stuck in the past and are forever unchanging as they want to preserve whatever it is they've been doing, regardless of whether or not it makes any sense. Maybe it's the fear of being controversial or being a heretic in the eyes of their fellow instructors, black belts, or masters. I feel that an art or organization which is unwilling to change cannot grow or survive. I've been greatly influenced by some of the more progressive martial arts thinkers that have taken a hard look at their systems in an effort to improve functionality and effectiveness for self-defense. A number of these pioneers have certainly received as much criticism as they have praise, but I think it should serve as a badge of honor for these brave martial artists, because I feel that the trail they blaze is the path of the future for traditional-minded martial artists, such as myself. Many of these martial artists have modernized their training practices to a degree which enables their practitioners to be more effective without losing their traditional roots. Most of these critics can only cite reasons such as, "That's not how we've always done it," or some other nonsense such as that. This is the path I choose as well. My mission is to further break down and fully dissect the material and draw possible practical applications for the purpose of self-defense. Most people in the martial arts world know this in Japanese as Bunkai, but since our style is Korean, we use the same characters that translate as Bunhae. Let's see where this path of discovery to functional practicality leads. I hope you'll join me in this journey.